The world! 時を止まれ!
Yes! Yes! Alrighty, so as I'm sure a lot of you know already, YBA updated yesterday and they released voice lines back into the game. Well, I guess released isn't really the right word, it's more like re-added. They didn't add all of them back though, and I'm not entirely sure why. I think I have a pretty decent idea as to why, but I'll talk about that later, probably towards the end of the video. Just because I want to cover all of the update first before I start talking about that kind of stuff and theories and all that nonsense. Basically, when it comes to voice lines, I think most of the things are back. Well, at least when it comes to barrages, barrage finishers, and some of the special moves. I know Time Stops have their voice lines back, but any new special that's been added does not. So stuff like Road Roller, as I showed earlier, GER doesn't have its Return to Zero lines back, and all of the new stands don't have any voice lines at all still because they didn't have them before. So barrages for stuff like The World Over Heaven or Made in Heaven still have no sound. This is obviously a very, very good step in the right direction, but it does kind of confuse me that they didn't add all of them back and they only chose to add some of them back. It's just weird, but I'm sure we'll get the rest of them back eventually, so it's probably not that huge of a deal. I will say the one thing that I'm not sure if we'll get back is the music. We'll see about that. I know that stuff like the Awakening music is still the same, and I'm not entirely sure if that's gonna switch or if it's gonna stay whatever the hell it is right now, but I suppose only time will tell when it comes to that kind of stuff. Now I'm gonna start going over all of the stuff that's actually in the update, and I'll cover it as best I can. So the first thing that we're gonna start off with is the Six Pistols rework. And oh boy, how do I feel about this? It's a nightmare. I don't know what the hell they were thinking. They decided to take the most obnoxious thing about Six Pistols, the being able to dash while stunned, and add an actually good moveset on top of that. Why would you do this? I don't understand. Come on. I hate Six Pistols. It's the most frustrating thing in the entire game to play against. I genuinely have no idea what the hell they thought they were doing when they were doing this rework. The one thing that might have balanced this is if they took away the dashes, and they didn't. They left it exactly the same. So now Six Pistols has a massive damage output, and can just dodge out of all your stuff. It's ridiculous. I mean, just look at this nonsense. This man landed one projectile and did half of my HP. If I catch him, I do like 4 damage and he dashes away. What the hell is this? Come on, please, Uzu, what were you thinking, dude? I've had people sending me clips on Discord about some of the nonsense you can do with the new rework, and apparently it can one combo with spin, I believe. So, oh lord, the future is scary. Whatever, I could be here all day complaining about the stupid Six Pistols rework, so I think we better move on. Next up, vampires regenerate their limbs 2 times faster. I think this change is probably pretty good because Vampire needed help, and I don't know any ways to buff it without making it just stupidly OP and destroying anything that isn't Haman, so I'm glad we got a small change for that that might help its viability. I don't really see this being all that helpful, but who knows, maybe it'll be helpful in the long run. I'm glad for you vamp mains that actually got something worthwhile, and I suppose time will tell whether or not this change actually helps anything or not. Who knows, we'll see. They say here that they made the floors and walls of Coco Jumbo, which is Mr. President's room, a little bit thicker, so it should be harder to throw you out of it. This is something that I'm sure a lot of you have encountered already, where someone traps you in the room and they ragdoll you and you just fly through and automatically die. It's really frustrating to deal with, so I'm glad this should hopefully fix it. We'll see. All the quote-unquote bug fixes they add usually have some sort of stigma attached. Hopefully this one doesn't. We'll see how it works out, but all in all, a really, really good change. Now, whether or not my video about Star Platinum the World was heated or not is up in the air. I'm assuming probably not, because they decided to buff Star Platinum the World, which is a good thing, considering that I felt like it did need some buffs, or at least changes. But what they decided to buff feels like all the wrong things. They buffed Skullcrusher damage, which is a move that you can never land anyway. So that does absolutely nothing. And they added an increase in damage to the Awakening. So the Awakening's worth getting now, sure. But it doesn't really change a whole lot since you can't land most of your moves. All this really does is give you a small amount of gimmick mode while you have your Awakening active where you can do more damage. In other words, charge your Haman, use Awakening, and land a beatdown so that your beatdown just does more damage. Effectively what this did is a whole lot of nothing. Star Platinum of the World still has to rely entirely on its time stop and its beatdown to get damage, and the Awakening is not going to change too much considering that it has such a long cooldown, and your opponents can try to just time you out most of the time until it's over. I'm not entirely sure why they decided to go about changing Star Platinum of the World this way, especially the Skullcrusher damage. That just has me scratching my head, because that move is worthless, so increasing the damage doesn't really make any sense. I was hoping that they would make it so, the Slam would block break, but it's still bad. So Star Platinum of the World, people have been telling me that I should redo my review, and I don't think I have to, because pretty much everything I said still applies. Just because they added what's basically gimmick mode where you can do more damage, that doesn't change the fact that you have to rely entirely on beatdown and time stop in order to get any damage. So that's how I feel about the Star Platinum of the World changes. Next up, they decided that 70% damage cap, by the way, wasn't good enough, so now it's 50% damage cap, by the way. They made it so that the maximum amount of damage you can do in a time stop is now linked to 50% damage max instead of 70% damage max. Other than the fact that it just straight up doesn't work, who's surprised? Certainly not myself. This is a really, really stupid change. Time Stop as a whole needs a complete rework, and it's just not getting it, and at this point, I don't think it's ever going to get it. As Time Stop is right now, it kinda just sucks for everything that isn't the World Over Heaven and Star Platinum the World, and every single change that they're doing doesn't change that fact. All they're doing is making it so that some of the upgrades are now completely worthless to unlock. Why would you ever unlock all of the Time Stop nodes for the World Over Heaven if you can't even do more than 50% damage with it? What's the purpose of doing any more damage in someone's time stop if it doesn't do anything? That's the thing. Attacks shouldn't just stop doing damage. You need to rework the thing from the ground up so that time stop physically cannot do 70% damage or over. Make it so that time stop is impossible to do 100% of someone's health. That way, you don't need to put any of these silly caps on it. But I don't think that's gonna happen. They'll probably just keep putting these band-aid fixes on it and hope it works. Which is really a shame, but I don't see it going anywhere anytime soon, and there's not really a whole lot I can do about it, so oh well. They've increased the cooldown for both GER's counter and Steel Balls, the regular Steel Ball. As for the GER counter, I was using it myself and I didn't really notice that much of a difference, but I honestly don't use GER's counter as much as I probably should, so I don't know exactly how much this affects GER, but it really doesn't need the counter to begin with, so I don't think this is a bad change. In fact, I would say it's a really good change, because the counter is kind of stupid and I'm glad it's getting some nerfs. As for the Steel Balls, thank God, this doesn't really fix the issue with Funny Spin doing 80% of your health, but it does make it a little bit more bearable, because now if you block a Spin Ball, they don't just get another one in like 4 seconds. I myself don't use Spin, so I can't vouch for exactly how much longer it is, but I've been told by some of my friends that it's pretty substantial, and it should help dealing with the Funny Spin people who just wait and then throw Steel Balls at you and do 70% of your health. It's not a thing of the past by any means, but this should help to lower it at least a little bit. Now, as for the rest of the changes in the changes section of the patch notes, they added a new face for Heaven Ascension Dio, which I haven't seen myself. They changed some model stuff on Star Platinum, which I'm also not entirely sure what it is. They removed the third leg off of Star Platinum in the World, finally. And they added a new face to Sea Moon, which just kind of looks constipated. That's what some of the people in my chat told me, and I'm inclined to agree. I wish I had a screenshot of it, but unfortunately I do not. But with that, I think we can move into the bug fixes, where I really get happy, because some of the things I've been complaining about big time did finally get fixed. I'm gonna skip over the changes to the Stand Reroll Game Pass, because frankly, I don't care, and you shouldn't be buying this anyway. Don't give Uzu money. But the real first bug fix on here is one that I didn't think would ever get patched, so I'm really impressed it did, which is the Barrage Immune bug. The reason I didn't think it would get patched is because not a lot of people knew exactly how it worked. The reason I know that is because I didn't see people constantly abusing it everywhere I went. Basically, if you hit someone with one singular hit of your spec barrage, so if you just tapped Sunlight Yellow, or I'm not entirely sure you could do it with Boxing Barrage, but I'm sure you could, it would make that person completely immortal to barrages until they died. This meant that they could have a massive leg up because their main combo breaking tool, Barrage, was just completely out of the question. So they could just kind of run at you and barrage you and you couldn't do anything back to them. It was really stupid. But thankfully, that's a thing of the past, so it's gone. Good riddance. Whatever glitch people were doing in order to get Requiem stands into casual SBR has been fixed. I thought this was fixed before, but evidently not, and now it's gone. So if you were abusing that, first of all, you probably got banned. Second of all, you're a scumbag, and third, you can't do it anymore. The goddamn aura beatdown invincibility nonsense that people were doing in main game to cheese bosses and absolutely ruin my life is finally gone. So thank God. This took way too long to patch, but hey, I'm just happy it's gone. Honestly though, in my opinion, it's kind of a shame that this got patched, because I was really looking forward to getting a bunch of people banned for abusing this in main game, since glitch abuse in main game is bannable now. But hey, I think I'd rather have it patched than have to go through the headache of reporting all the scumbags that were abusing this in main game. Another one that I'm surprised got fixed is that you can no longer use Time Erase to permanently trap people in Mr. President's room. For those who are unaware, you used to be able to go into Mr. President's room with someone else, use Time Erase, and then have the Mr. President empty the room, and when you let go of Time Erase, since when you used it you were in the room and so was the other person, they would get TP'd back and be stuck there forever. I didn't see too many people using this, but it was really obnoxious when they would, and since I didn't see it that often, I'm pretty surprised it got fixed, but I'm glad it did. Now, the next one's really, really big, and I'm very, very glad it got fixed, because it might have been one of the most annoying bugs in the game, and that's your stand lagging behind you. It specifies here during time stop, but as far as I'm aware, this applies to time skip as well. For anyone that somehow has never run into this bug, and frankly, I don't believe you if you say you've never seen it, when you would time stop or time skip, your stand would start like lagging behind you, it wouldn't be attached to your character anymore, and it would make it so your hitboxes just straight up didn't work. It made being offensive with time skip really hard for using anything that wasn't a spec move, because you'd TP to the person, you'd use a move, and your stand would throw it out, but they'd be so far behind you that it just wouldn't be close enough to hit. I'm ashamed to admit that I didn't think this would get patched out, but even so, the fact that it did makes me really happy, and it'll make playing the TS stands that have Time Skip and King Crimson a whole lot easier now that I can actually use Time Skip offensively, and you don't have to completely throw yourself into the gutter by putting your stand away and taking it back out after you get time stopped. Now, I'm kind of gonna blow through the last few because I don't think they're that important, but Mr. President's room emptying is no longer global. I didn't even know this was the case, but apparently before, if you emptied the room, it would empty everyone else's room. I'm not sure how the hell this was even the case, but looks like it's been fixed. You can't fling yourself by dashing backwards after using the hand's erasure accelerate. This doesn't fix the main problem with the hand, being that you can just go into walls with it, but hey, I'll take what I can get. You can't pose anymore in someone else's time stop. Previously, if you posed and then somebody time stopped, you'd continue posing and gain your health back, but it looks like that's been patched out. And finally, they fixed a data leak, which should help in main game. Basically, what having a data leak means is that the longer a server is up, the laggier and laggier it'll get because things either need to be loaded or I don't exactly know the technical side of it. But what you need to know is servers being up for a long time won't lag as much as they did before. And with that, that's all the patch notes for the update. Now, how I feel about it? Well, it's kind of mixed. I am really, really happy with all of the bug fixes, and I'm honestly shocked that we got an update that had majority of its things being fixes and changes rather than new content. As I'm sure you've seen me say before, I basically only expect Uzu to ever put things out that are new content because that brings in the most players. But after bringing stand sounds back, that seemed to pull in a lot of people. and the numbers went up again. So hopefully what this means is that Uzu will see that people do want bug fixes, but I don't know if he's gonna see that. He's probably just gonna think it's the voice lines, and honestly, he's probably right. I doubt many people care all that much about bug fixes, and certainly not as much as I do. But hey, I got a lot of bug fixes out of it. I'm happy. Now, I'm not all happy because the Six Pistols rework is a complete disaster. I don't think they tested it whatsoever because it's a nightmare to fight against. I never thought that they'd manage to make something that's more annoying to fight than the old Six Pistols, and then they added the new Six Pistols. It's basically just spin, but again. So now you can run spin with spin. Awesome. The other thing is that quite a few of the massive bugs that I was hoping would get fixed did not. I can't be complaining too much on this one considering that they fixed a lot of the bugs, but stuff like projectiles going backwards wasn't fixed, which I don't know if it can be fixed based on what people have told me, but one thing that I know can be fixed is that the projectiles and time stops still don't work. Knives are still completely worthless in your TS and you just can't use them. It's really annoying, honestly, and really a shame. It's a real killjoy now that I can use my TS sound effects and feel all cool when I time stop, and then my knives all don't work and I look like a jackass. Another thing, as I'm sure you may have seen in the gameplay, the scary monster's bricking bug still isn't fixed. If you get ragdolled while in your stand form in time stop with scary monsters, you just can't play the game anymore. That's annoying. Seamoon still makes you do push-ups when he counters a lot of the time. Not sure how they could fix that, but it's frustrating. And Tusk Act 4's nails still have lots of problems. Namely, that you can just block after getting hit by the first regular nail, and his wormhole nails still get absorbed by the wall. I'm sure there's a lot of other bugs that I could list off, but those are the main ones that I feel need to get fixed. I could, of course, mention the dashes being tied to frame rate, but that's one of those things that I can't see ever getting fixed. So I've basically just given up at this point. But who knows, I've been surprised before, just like right now, and hopefully I'll be surprised in the future. The very last thing that I want to talk about before I sign off is why exactly I think this update came out in the first place, and why some of the things feel incomplete. I know a lot of you are probably asking, well, why bother re-adding some of the voice lines and not adding the rest? Or why are the stand names still butchered but the sound effects are back? And the answer to that is obviously ambiguous. I have a personal theory. I think that the game that shall not be named, if you know you know, put a lot of pressure on them and they panicked and just kind of pressed the release button before the update was done, but who knows, that's just what I think, and it doesn't have any credibility, so you can choose to believe whatever you want to believe. With all that being said, this video has gone on for frankly way too long. If you enjoyed this video, I don't know why you would. I basically just read through the patch notes for you. You can go read them yourself, but if you did enjoy it, go ahead and leave a like and subscribe. The only reason I made it is because I had a bunch of people asking me to, so for those of you that asked, I hope I didn't disappoint. And that's all I got, so have a wonderful day or night wherever you are, and I'll see you next time.